Hi, if you're having seizures, the first thought will be, am I having brain tumor? Well, luckily, the brain tumors are a small percentage of seizures. However, if you have a brain tumor, the chances of seizures are very, very high. They can happen in 80% of benign tumors or low-grade tumors, and it can be in 50% of aggressive tumors or high-grade tumors such as glioblastoma. And the treatment is totally different between the regular epilepsy and tumor-related epilepsy, which we will be discussing in details today. The trajectory of normal epilepsy is usually a predictable trajectory of one line and then improvement with treatment. However, in brain tumor, the trajectory is very volatile and changes so much with the course of the brain tumor and the treatment of it. Today, I will give you all the information and the experience I collected from my own brain tumor-related epilepsy clinic. To clarify, when we talk about brain tumors, we have three possibilities. The first possibility is low-grade tumors or very slow-growing tumors such as glioma. And the second possibility, which is rapidly growing tumors and aggressive tumors such as high-grade gliomas and glioblastomas. And the third type is if there is a tumor in the body, there's a cancer in the body, and then that cancer spreads to the brain, which is called brain metastasis. And this is the third type of the brain-related tumor. Well, how can brain tumors cause epilepsy and seizures? There are multiple different mechanisms. The first thing is that physically irritating the brain. When the tumor grows, it will physically irritate the brain cells, and that can cause seizures. And the second thing is that the brain tumors are producing chemicals and toxins. The same thing like if you're having a factory near the river and the factory keeps dumping all the pollutants and toxins into the river and affecting the area and the neighborhood. And for this irritation to lead to seizures, it can take a long time, and that is why the low-grade tumors are slowly growing. They can cause more seizures than the aggressive and fast-growing the aggressive brain tumor. And one new discovery of the genes of the brain tumors found that if there is a mutation in one of the enzymes called IDH1, if there is a mutation in IDH1, that mutation can tend to cause more seizures than if there is no mutation. And on the other side, if there is a mutation in that, usually it causes a more favorable outcome and a less aggressive brain tumor. How do seizures look like in brain tumors? Well, the seizures can vary so much based on where the seizures are happening and which area is being involved. So it can be motor, means movement, shaking, if it's in the motor area. If it's in the sensation area, it will be abnormal sensation. If it's in the vision area, it will be abnormal seeing stars or other vision phenomena. And it can be so many different types based on where the seizures are happening and which area of the brain is involved. There's one question that, should I take anti-seizure medications if I have a brain tumor or brain metastasis with no seizures and epilepsy yet, kind of to prevent the seizures from happening? Well, this question was heavily researched, and the recommendation and the guidelines from multiple neuro-oncology societies recommended that there should be no treatment for brain tumors to prevent seizures from happening, because the medications and anti-seizure medications, they could not prevent seizures from happening, and they also can cause side effects which can affect the patient's quality of life. And we can give anti-seizure medications during the time of the surgery. If we're doing surgery, we're cutting the brain, we can give medication just for about 7 days to prevent seizures from happening. If nothing happens, we can take off the medication right away. And if seizures happen, then yes, we can treat them, but we don't give medication to prevent seizures from happening. What is the course of the treatment for seizure-related epilepsy? Well, here is the difference. In tumor-related seizures and epilepsy, the course of seizures is very volatile and changing with time. Usually there are ups and downs. What happened is that at the beginning, usually there are lots of seizures happening because of the diagnosis of the brain tumor and irritation to the brain. And then we start the treatment. We do the surgery, and that surgery also can take out the tumor, but you know, in the healing process, that can cause inflammation and irritation to the brain, and seizures can transiently get worse. And then they will get better after the tumor is out. And then we do chemotherapy and radiation therapy. So chemotherapy, radiation therapy will focus on the remnant of the tumor or the tumor itself, and that can cause killing of those cells and the spillage of what the content is, and the content usually is irritant to the brain, and that can lead to worsening of the seizures. And then we give more medications to control that, and then the seizures will eventually calm down and improve. And, you know, see up and down, up and down. And then the seizures can be quiet for some time, especially at the first initial treatment, which usually is successful in most of the patients. However, the brain tumor will wake up again, especially in aggressive brain tumors. They will not be cured completely, and there will be a remnant that will grow back. And the first sign of tumor growing back can be that the seizures are coming back. So I had patients who had like no seizures for 1 or 2 years after the treatment, and then all of a sudden the seizure starts. We do a scan, and the seizures and the scan will show that the tumor is growing back. And the more advanced the tumor will be, the more aggressive and harder to control seizures, and also the patients will be more sensitive to medication. So it is a very, very ups and down, and the course changes so much. The plan that I will put one day, it can be different from the second day because of this dynamic changes and dynamic effects of the brain tumor that I would like to always explain ahead of time on the first visit for all my patients who have brain tumors and seizures. How can we treat brain tumor and seizures? Well, the first thing is that my first focus on the treatment of the seizures is the quality of life of the patient and taking a holistic approach for them. So it is important when we consider treatment, we should consider how the seizures can affect the patient and how the treatment can also affect the patient, because lots of patients will be sensitive to medications and have side effects from them. And when we plan any surgical treatment for the tumor itself, if the tumor has no seizures, we'll be just restricting whatever you see on the scan. But if there is epilepsy associated with the tumor, then we modify the tumor surgery to do epilepsy surgery as well, so that sometimes we extend beyond the borders of the tumor if that area is irritated and causing seizure. And due to the volatile nature of the tumor, we always have a plan for treatment, and that will change so much as we treat. So when there is like a beginning of the treatment will be medications, and then the patient might run into side effects, and then we lower the medications when the seizures are controlled, then we'll be good for some time, and then the tumor will grow back, or we do radiation and chemotherapy, and then seizures will get worse, then we go up on the medication, there will be some side effects, and then we go down to tolerate the side effects, and so on. So it's kind of like very dynamic treatment process. And the second thing is that there is no specific medication that can be the solution for seizures and epilepsy. Even though there are some studies suggesting that valproic acid or Depakote can slow the tumor progression by slowing the mechanism that grows the tumor, but the studies here are not very solid. And the other thing is that we should consider the interactions between the medications for seizures and the other treatments, such as chemotherapy and other treatments for the patient, because all of them, the chemotherapeutic agents, most of them, they will get degraded and processed in the liver. And if we give a medication that affects liver enzymes, such as carbamazepine and phenytoin, they can induce the liver enzyme and makes those chemotherapeutic agents less effective because it will be processed faster. And other medications that can slow the liver enzyme from processing the medications will be accumulation of the chemotherapeutic agents such as valproic acid or Depakote, and that can induce higher doses of the medication and the chemotherapy agent that can induce toxicity or more side effects. So it's a balance between those two. Also, we should know the background of the patient, and one of the common medications that are used is Levetiracetam or Keppra. But we should know that Keppra is an excellent medication for seizures and epilepsy. However, it can have side effects of mood, depression, anxiety, and also it can worsen anger and all of that, which is common in patients who are dealing with difficult lifetime and brain tumors. And we found that people who have frontal lobe brain tumors, they tend to have more psychiatric side effects and more psychiatric issues because the control of the self and the psychiatry is mostly in the frontal lobe. And one of the hot medications for brain tumors and epilepsy is Perampanel or Fycompa. And this medication has been studied a lot in epilepsy, and we are still studying it. But we should know that Fycompa also can have lots of psychiatric side effects, especially at higher doses, more than 6 milligrams, 6 and higher to 12. And it is safer in low doses of 2 to 4 milligrams. The new studies show that this does not cause as much psychiatric side effects as the higher dose. And there are multiple medications that we can use that do not affect the liver enzymes and they are safe usually on the body, such as this list of medication, that all of them are good choices for tumor-related epilepsy. And recently, there is a approval of one new medication that is so good and works very well for seizures. And I have used it in patients who have very poorly controlled epilepsy and seizures after brain tumors, which is medication called cenobamate. And I made a whole video explaining what is that medication and how does it work. And as you can see, there are lots of anti-seizure medications, and every one of them has a different mechanism. And if one medication fails to control the seizures, we tend to add the second medication and even the third medication and replace them one by one. And to be smart, we should always add a medication that has a different mechanism of action. And to learn all about how the medication works and what's the mechanism of action and which is the right medication for you, you can see all of that in one video that I made about anti-seizure medications here. And stay healthy, and see you in the next one. Salam.